Hello, Young Justice fans. Dark Superboy here for you with another video on our favourite superhero season, series, and TV show, Young Justice Outsiders. Today we will be breaking down the newly released trailer. Less than 24 hours, guys, so watch that before watching this, because I shall give you a warning of potential spoilers and speculation for those who have not seen it. As well as, if you want to keep everything completely as a surprise, by all means, stop now. Okay? Fair warning, starting in 3, 2, 1. Okay. Right, let's start off first with how it opens. It opens very similar to the original Young Justice Invasion trailer, with a catch-up of the entire previous season's event. I think that was a very good call. A bit annoying for any true Young Justice fan who hasn't forgotten, particularly since those last first few minutes were a bit agonising after having to wait 5 years. But again, I enjoyed the similarities. I'd like to point out that the clips shown in this trailer are probably only going to be within the first 1 to 5 episodes of the season 3, because as you can hear from some of the editing when you watched the sound editing, Lobo's punch, Connor's punches to Lobo didn't quite match up sound effect wise, so it's still in production process, so obviously they're not going to have anything ready to show, so expect this to have only the first 1 to 5 episodes in, so still plenty of new stuff to see. We all start off with a older looking Artemis being woken up by a older looking Bruce Lee. Obviously that's continuing in a time jump, just like between seasons 1 and 2. I'm saying 2 to 3 years, and judging by what I've seen, that's probably still an accurate statement. You've got the cute Artemis Wally Bruce Lee photo before she gets up, and I'm still convinced she's being portrayed as a single mum this season, because that mysterious JW didn't show up this trailer. Oh, Greg Wiseman, you are so annoying with your little clues and don't give away anything. Next, we have the Cat Grant on television reporting on Markovia, but if we know, it is a Galaxy Broadcasting System. So, by now, with the help of Young Justice and the Justice League and the alien technology they've acquired, Earth is stepping into the role of a more galactic scale by obviously broadcasting this to other worlds. Obviously that is a bit dangerous, but it's probably a nice olive branch. So yes, next, and this is probably going to be the setup for the first couple of episodes, we've got the Markovian country mentioning the kidnapping of their young princess Terra Markov, which is actually Terra from the Teen Titans. In response, the Young Justice team send over their stealth team of Dick Grayson and Artemis to scout out the area. It's discovered that Prince Markov, second heir to the throne, is discovered to have the metagene, and if you look in the background when he's told this, you see the queen and king's portraits up on the wall. Now, does this signify they've been killed? And if so, it's got to be someone close to them. I'm guessing it is this Gregor, as shown in the images to be Crown Prince, which for those who are not up to date with royal etiquette, that means the next in line for the throne. Brian Markov is prince because he's still the son of a king, but he's not the next in line in throne. So potentially Markov set this whole thing up to get rid of his sister, get rid of his parents, to get to the throne. That's only a guess, but it would make sense, and obviously brings a bit of an evil potentially light to the world. Okay, one thing before I skip over this. obviously, in order to, if the Self Team wants to get closer to the royal family, then potentially Artemis is going to have to do a bit of undercover seduction, which enforces my idea, this my theory in my previous post of her potentially starting a romantic relationship with Prince Markov. I know Spitfires don't want to hear this, but it's been several years. We don't want her to be sad forever. Well, I am an adamant Spitfire fan. Don't hate me. Okay, next we go on to the League of Shadows. We've got Sensei here dodging a lava blast, which is Geoforce's staple move of being able to throw magma. So obviously if he's find out that League of Shadows has helped abduct their sister, he's going to be coming for them. We've also got Cheshire in the mix. So that's probably a continuation of the kidnapping story. So I'm thinking episode 2, maybe 3. We've got Batman versus Bane. Who doesn't like seeing that? I don't think we're going to have the broken bat situation, but this is just a regular fisticuffs for them. We've got a lot of images of the new gods and what I believe to be, within 100% conviction, to be another planet, thus all the aliens seen in it. So we're doing another off-world episode, so like Earthlings. again, similar to season 2 in one of the first couple of episodes. So it's going to be the kidnapping situation, the Markov situation, going off to Earth with the rest of the team, and then back with new information. But yeah, obviously that is new Genesis, new gods, Orion's scene in there. That's probably going to be set up for one episode itself. We have a brief appearance of Count Vertigo, royalty of another European country. So if the Light are trying to create a power base in Europe, if you've got the Markovians on one side and you've got Vertigo's country on the other, that is a big power base in Europe. And considering they've already got Asia with the North and South Eurasia Alliance, helped by Lex Luthor in season 1, and it's beginning to cover a lot of the world of having multiple bases, particularly Middle East with Queen Bee. So the Light is setting up multiple groupings of their base of organisations, expanding influence. Also, I think a lovely little bit of transaction continuing on from season 2 and season 3 will be the introduction of how the new heroes are introduced to us. I think it's going to be similar to season 2, where you had the new teammates hunting down Clayface and the reveal of the changes and the time gap. I think it's going to be done season 3-wise. A similar way, because you have an image of Arrowette versus Clayface. I think that would be a nice little Easter egg. Ode to season 2 that way. I don't think it's going to be a full episode, just a kind of opening starter, and then lead into the other episodes, which I will get into. So I'm committing to this belief that the episode season 3 will go as follows. You will have most likely a double bill two-parter feature of the Markovia situation, which would be the Stealth Team going to Markovia and the setup for that, and the rescue of the people in Markovia and Geostorm becoming a hero. Episode 3 will most likely be the off-world episode with the new gods, Blue Beetle and Impulse being off-world. And episode 4 will be an episode magic-related, because you've got all that, those images of 13, Artemis and 13, Artemis 13 and Dr. Fate. So I think that's going to be the magic episode introducing 13 to the rest of the team. So that test spans about 4 episodes, which sums up my estimate of how many episodes they've got completed enough to put into this trailer. But I digress. So that's it. That's all the important bits that I caught in this trailer. If you think you've caught something that I haven't mentioned, by all means, comment below, like, subscribe, and let me generally know what you think. I've been Dark Superboy. This has been a video for Young Justice and for the fans. Thank you. Please comment, like, and subscribe. And until later, as always, let hope burn bright. Goodbye.